Hello everyone. So guys, in this video we are going to see what is reinforced earth wall. We are also going to see the function of the parts of RE wall. And before moving further, I want to tell you is that I am going to come up with a lot of informative content in future, and I am working on that. So those who haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you don't miss any updates in future. So let's start. So I am giving you the definition of RE wall first, then I am going to explain you step by step what does the definition mean in the upcoming slides. These pictures will help us in understanding or having the clear picture of what is RE wall. So let's have a definition. It is basically a composite structure which consists of alternating layers of compacted soil and soil reinforcement elements fixed to a wall facing. The stability of RE wall is due to friction and tension between backfill and soil reinforcement. The main function of wall is preventing erosion of structural backfill. Main function of wall means precast wall. So the resulting structure which we get is a coherent gravity structure that is flexible and can carry a variety of heavy loads. So that was a definition. Now let's understand with the help of pictures what does RE wall mean. So here you can see these precast panels of concrete. This is the soil in between. So in this picture you can see these are the precast blocks which are erected or which are being erected on one side, and similar blocks are present on the other side also, and in between we have a soil backfill which we retain to get a elevated structure which usually connects your flyovers and bridges in the beginning. So basically what we do is, like in every structure, initially we provide PCC panels as a bed for RE wall, and for other structure also we do it the same thing. So in this case we provide the bed for these PCC panels which are usually of 150 by 350 mm, and they act as a bed, means they provide cushion to this structure. So if you see these precast panels, these are basically casted in factory unlike at site, because we need to complete the work in a very less time so that we can save cost and time also. It would be good for any firm. And these precast panels come with a prefabricated grooves so that it is easy to fix them one by one at site. So let's move on to the second picture. This is, you see, when you come across any existing RE wall, like if the RE wall is under construction and you are passing by this area, you see almost a structure like this which is partly erected. So this is the outer face of RE wall, and inside I shown you that how the backfill is placed and how this is erected. So basically if you see the soil which is retained inside is compacted highly to give a very high density, and these precast walls which are erected at site, these are directly transported from factory to site, and here they are being unloaded with the help of this hydra and stored at site. So I have already explained you that precast panels are interlocked within each other with the help of grooves which are provided in the factory while manufacturing of these precast panels. So these are the perforated pipes which we use. If you can see in this picture, this is a drain which through in which we have inserted pipe, and it helps in draining out all the moisture and excess water through this pipe. So these are perforated pipes. In the second picture you can see there are so many perforations present on the pipe, and if you see there are around in a single pipe there are around 50% perforations present on a pipe, and these pipes are basically of a 160 mm diameter. So I've already explained you what is the main function of these pipes. These drain out the excess water and moisture from the soil. Now this is a geocomposite sheet. Now the function of geocomposite sheet is, if you can see in the first picture, these geocomposite sheets are wrapped around the edges of these precast panels. And in second picture, if you see this, if you see at the bottom, this is the geocomposite sheets which are being wrapped on pipe. And I have already explained you that these are the pipes which are having perforations on them. So the geocomposite sheets are wrapped on them because I will explain you the basic function of geocomposite sheet. These geocomposite sheets basically absorb water from the soil, and the excess water which they absorb is like they are passed to the perforated pipes through which it is drained out of the structure. So why we are using this geocomposite sheets? Why not we are using the pipes only? Because these geocomposite sheets have very small pores through which the water can pass easily, and if we allow pipes to drain all the moisture and water, we may find in future that the soil is also passing, because the soil particles are also very small and they are also likely to pass with the water. So in future we may find that there may be a case of soil erosion, that the soil has passed with the water through the pipes. So that may create a instability in the structure. So these geocomposite sheets contain very small pores, and with the help of these pores the water is passed at a very small rate, and this water pass in the pipes, in the drain pipes, and eventually it goes out of the structure. So basically we have seen these geocomposite sheets prevents soil erosion, and also the water which is being collected in the soil has to be drained out because it will create excess hydrostatic pressure that will be an excess load to the structure. Now if you see, this is the precast panel, this is the precast panel, and this one is the second precast panel. Now we tie these precast panel with the help of these wooden rods, wooden locks and mini tie bars. So initially they are being supported with the help of this wooden logs and mini tie bars, and later on they are removed when the structure is about to complete. So we do this because initially we need alignment, because we need our structure to be aligned in a proper line or in a proper plane. If you see this wedge, this is a triangular wedge. This also helps in the alignment of the RE wall, and the precast panel doesn't go out of the plane if we use these wooden wedges. So we insert these wedges in the spaces which are there present between the two different precast panels. So our main function of these wooden bars is to keep the alignment intact and in place. Now if you see this is EPDM pad, you might have heard of this. This is a kind of synthetic rubber. So the function of this synthetic rubber or EPDM pad is, it absorbs shocks and impact loads, so it avoids the friction. It avoids friction between the two precast panels. And if we'll not provide these pads, what will happen is
the load will directly transfer to the soil, and the impact load will also transfer to the precast panels. So the precast panels, there are chances that they may crack due to friction, which can develop due to vehicular loads or live loads. So this EPDM pad absorbs all the shocks which arise due to vehicular load and eventually pass in the precast panels. So basically, you might have seen these EPDM pads or synthetic rubber kind of thing under bridges also. So if you see at the supports, these acts like a shock absorber under the bridges also, above the pile. These are present between the superstructure and substructure. These prevent or these absorb impact loads which develops due to the movement of vehicles. Now the reinforcement which I was talking about in the beginning is this. This is a geogrid strip. Now if you see from where it comes, these geogrid strips are manufactured in the factory and they come in the form of rolls. So this geogrid we use with the soil as a reinforcement. Like in the beginning I said that the stability is due to friction between backfill and soil reinforcement. So the backfill is our soil which we have already placed, and this is the geogrid which is of main importance in this RE wall. So this is the most important part which we use to construct RE wall, and its main function is it acts as a reinforcement. So what it does is it produces tension, or it absorbs tension, like we have RCC in which the concrete absorbs compression and steel is good in tension. So we provide them both all together so that tension and compression can be resisted simultaneously. So in this case, the soil and this geogrid is used together to prevent tension, and it maintains the stability of soil. So if you see the geogrid is attached to this precast panels like this. So the tie rod is passed through these grooves which are already present in the precast panels, and through which these geogrids are tied on one face of the precast panels. So if you see in the second picture, so these geogrids, what we do is we pull them apart and we create a tension in them. And in the next slide I'm going to show you how these are being held in the soil. So this geogrid is pulled apart and it is tied to a U member, which is a steel member, and there it is tied and being buried in the soil itself at the center. So if the passage is, there is one side, this is the one side of the panel and there is the other side of the panel. So what we do is we pass geogrid, or we tie this geogrid from the first face of the panel, and till here we bring this geogrid and tie it with a U-shaped bar, and it just gets buried in the soil. So similarly, from other face of the panel also we carry out the same process. We bring the GOD from that face of the panel, and in the center we tie it to the U-shaped bar and we put it in the soil. And what happens next is we compact the soil, with alternative layer of soil, so it gets buried within the soil. Now what is the main function of this geogrid wall? This basically creates the interlocking between the soil or the granular material, whatever we use, like we can use soil also or some granular material also. So it creates interlocking between soil and this geogrid, and it is a very strong in tension, and it actually is used to reinforce the retained soil. So geogrid also, if you see the geogrid is tied to the precast panels, so what it will do is It will also help the precast panels to remain in position, or the alignment will be, it will maintain the alignment of these precast panels, so that due to soil pressure, these precast panel doesn't go out of the plane. And the next advantage is, it is very cheap in comparison to steel reinforcement. Like if we use steel reinforcement in place of these geogrids, the cost would be high. Now these geogrids are synthetic rubber, so the cost which will incur is very less in comparison to our steel reinforcement. So there are so many advantages of using this geogrid instead of using steel reinforcement. I hope I have made myself clear on the portion of this, on the portion of function of this geogrid. Now this was the U members I was talking about. So like I already told you that these geogrid pass from these grooves, and in the center these are being tied to these U members. These U members, these pointed ends are buried inside the soil, and a layer of soil is placed over this, and it is compacted so that these U members can lie down inside the soil. So now what happens is, when the vehicular load comes, it creates pressure on the soil. So what happens is, the soil will exert pressure on the precast panels, and if we have provided the geogrid will come in tension. You can see in the previous slide. So if the soil will exert pressure, this geogrid soil will exert pressure on these precast panels, so these will try to go, these precast panels will try to move outwards, and due to this, the geogrid, this strip will come in tension, and from at the center it is already tied to a U member, so and at other end it is tied to these precast panels, so they will always remain in tension. So how this will save the structure from failing is, it will come in tension, but the soil above it will make an interlocking with this, and the friction will be created, so it will become difficult for the soil to move outwards, and this is how it is going to save these precast panels to move out of the plane. So it will save the structure from failing. These are the U-bar members which we use and which we put it inside the soil, and through which we tie the grid members, the other end of the grid geogrid. Next is this, we keep on tying this geogrid, and on the other end, if you see in this picture, see, if this is the face of the wall, and if you tie the geogrid to that U steel member, it is being buried in the center, and from that side also, from that wall also, the geogrid will come from, it will be tied to the facing panel of this precast panel, and on the other hand, at the center, it will be tied to the U-shaped bar. So like this, we are going to tie the geogrid, and we will again place the layer of soil, and like if you can see in the first picture, this roller, which is usually of 1 to 2 tons, because we use lightweight roller, because it create vibrations and impact, and due to which the alignment can be misplaced. So we use very light rollers to compact the soil, to compact the alternative layers of soil. So now in the second picture, if you see, the precast panels are used according to the drawings which we are given. Now if you see at the corners, this is the corner of the RE wall. So these corners, these can be of any size. So what we do is, these can be casted at site. These are mainly casted at site because the precast members of this size is usually not available. So now if you see like this, we keep rolling the alternating layer of soil, and we reach at the required height what we need using we reach at the required height, and we adopt the same process from the starting like we did in the beginning to after compacting each layer of soil. So like this, we can go to a height which is required. So I hope you got the concept of RE wall, how is it used and how is it constructed, the function of its parts which are being used in creating the RE wall or in building the RE wall, how the geogrid and geocomposite is functioning throughout the construction of the RE wall. So this was all about RE wall, and if you like the video, please subscribe the channel and also press the bell icon so that you don't miss out any important updates in future. So guys, thanks for watching, and please keep waiting for my next video, and it would be really interesting video. That is why I'm requesting you to please subscribe the channel, and that video I'm going to upload very soon. So see you in the next video. Thank you everyone.